it's Thomas here, and today we're gonna be taking a look at the Philips Coral Care Gen 2 LED light fixture. Wait a sec, that's not it, hold on. It's heavy. If you've been waiting for an LED that can replace your 8-bulb T5 fixture, is completely silent with no fans, practically maintenance-free, and has an IP65 waterproof rating that is easy to use and provides an even blanket of natural-looking diffused light to wrap the corals in your reef or ornamental algae in your marine planet tank from all angles, reducing shadowing and making sure your reef gets all the light it needs from day one to year five, then check out the Philips Coral Care Gen 2. I remember when I saw the Gen 1, I was totally blown away. The Gen 2 looks great. It's definitely geared towards reefers that like a brighter, whiter reef tank or have some specific or specialized needs, like, you know, a light fixture or aquarium that is silent. While many LED fixtures are similar, some stand out from the pack for one reason or another. Whether it's how the LEDs are distributed, the unique spectrum they provide, the form factor of the light, the control options it offers, the price point, or even other features, there's an LED option available for just about every kind of reefer. We're now seeing a new trend where LED fixtures are aiming for a flat, even, and diffused light, mimicking the ever-popular and widely successful T5 options. Whether it's in a strip or a panel, these fixtures just tend to be easier to use for the average reefer. Philips took the reefing world by storm with their original Coral Care LED fixture in 2015, changing the way many reefers and manufacturers looked at how you can use LEDs to create an even, diffused, and blended blanket of light to provide corals and other photosynthetic marine organisms with the energy they need to thrive. Their Gen 2 fixture upped the ante with a new, sleeker body and updates to the LED layout and diffuser to add some extra shimmer while keeping the silent, fanless design, IP65 waterproof rating, and incredibly easy to use app. In the box, you'll find the Coral Care Gen 2 along with the hanging kit. Inside the Coral Care LED controller box, you'll find the controller itself along with the power adapter. The Coral Care Gen 2 doesn't have any onboard controls, so you'll need to pick up the controller Gen 2 as well if you want to control it through the app, through your PC, or through a 0 to 10 volt control and your aquarium controller. The Philips Coral Care controller can serve up to 4 lights, and each fixture can easily cover a 24 by 24 inch footprint, which means the average reefer will only need to purchase a single controller for their setup. Both the fixture and the controller have a more industrial appearance, but I personally like that, especially because it comes with the benefit of the fixture being silent and waterproof with an IP65 rating. While it should definitely not go for a swim in your tank, it's gonna take a lot more punishment in the form of splashes and water than most other light fixtures that are available and not skip a beat. It does come at the cost of the fixture being on the heavier side, so you'll wanna make sure you're mounting it to something solid, preferably not just drywall. I do really like that they offer the fixture in both black and white, so you can match it to the tank furniture or to the room so that it blends in. Following that industrial theme, to connect the light to the controller, you'll open up the cover plate on the controller, feed the wire from the light into the controller box through one of the bottom ports, and clip the bare wires into the control board. Once you're done, it's just a matter of plugging the controller and light fixtures into power and downloading the app. Philips did also make a PC version of their software available for download and included dual channel 0 to 10 volt ports for use with popular aquarium controllers like Apex, which is great to see. Personally, I find the app works really well. It is simple and easy to use and offers 4 preset schedules to choose from if you want to keep it as simple and as plug and play as possible. If you prefer to make your own custom schedules to fine tune the lighting to your specific needs, that of course is also an option. The interface for creating a schedule is familiar and similar to other apps that I've used, and Philips has made choosing a spectrum really easy by giving you 2 sliders, one for color and one for intensity. You can choose between a whiter or bluer spectrum and adjust the overall intensity of the light. This way, it is virtually impossible to create a spectrum that could be detrimental to your corals. I was also really glad to see that Philips did include an acclimation mode, so if you're switching to this light from another one or you're adding new corals, you can ease them into their new environment. The app also allows you to toggle between Bluetooth and Wi-Fi control, since the controller offers both, and between the app or PC scheduler and the 0 to 10 volt ports, depending on how you plan to control the light. Philips did a good job when it comes to light spread and distribution, and the Coral Care performs almost exactly like an 8-bulb T5 fixture. It is also one of, if not the best performing LED light fixture when it comes to even spread when using multiple fixtures. The muted shimmer that the Coral Care provides is also going to be a big winner for those who prefer the look of T5 over the heavy caustic shimmer lines of other LED options that are available. The spectrum of the Coral Care is definitely unique, and it is certainly geared towards reefers that appreciate a more natural look of a whiter, brighter reef tank. It does have plenty of blue spectrum between 400 and 500 nanometers, but also includes enough amber and white diodes to create that natural ocean look with all channels at 100%. Those who like a bluer looking tank will find themselves turning the white channel down to about 30%, which is going to cut down on par, but still leaves plenty available for LPS and mixed tanks where SPS will be closer to the top. Personally, I see this fixture being phenomenal, not only just for mixed reef tanks, but also for those looking to do marine planted tanks filled with ornamental macroalgae, as well as photosynthetic gorgonian and sponge dominated systems, or even a biotope where the goal is to keep it as natural looking as possible. I'd even say reefers who just like to see both the fluorescence and natural pigments of their corals and fish will find the Coral Care a great way to observe both throughout the day with a fluorescent pop at the morning and night and natural pigments midday. For those reefers out there who absolutely must have a silent light fixture and are really sensitive to fan noise, or just really don't want to deal with the maintenance of moving parts getting clogged up with dust on their light fixtures, you will definitely find the Coral Care an attractive option. It doesn't make any noise, and short of dusting off the outside of it once in a while or wiping off unintended splashes, there aren't any fans to clog with dust in difficult to reach places, so you can do away with worrying about any of that. Silent, practically no maintenance. When it comes to cost per par, Philips did well, and although the Coral Care is one of the more expensive lighting options up front, it certainly isn't the most expensive when it comes to cost per par, but that does assume you do appreciate a whiter tank for at least a portion of the day. If you want to see how this light performed in the LED showdown where Ryan and Randy break down the top 20 LED light fixtures and, declare a winner essentially and grade all of them based on things like cost per par, you can check that out in this video right here. They go through all of it. If you've already got one of these, or you know you're gonna get one because some of these features really speak to you, you can check out Randy's Investigates to get the BRS recommended settings, all of the part charts, all that crazy technical data right down here. I know I don't usually give you two videos, but today you got two. Dealer's choice, whatever you prefer. Which one are you gonna pick? Huh?